What's going on, all of you fantastic freelancers? William here, and I bet you didn't expect me to be doing another video so soon. To be perfectly honest, neither did I, but considering I've been away so long, and considering our king Mark Darrah just tweeted out something pretty awesome, I couldn't resist. So yesterday, Jason Lionley tweeted to Mark if we would have to do a mission to unlock our javelins. For example, he wanted to know if he could play as the Colossus after the tutorial. Mark replied that, quote, "We originally were going to have the javelins tied to missions, but this resulted in them getting unlocked too late. As a result, you will instead be able to choose a suit to unlock at different level thresholds." Another freelancer followed that up by asking, "When was this decided? And does that mean each javelin is locked behind a specific level, i.e. the Colossus at 5? Storm at 10, and so on. Or are we given the option of any at a specific level?" Mark responded that you can choose which javelin you get at each level gate, except for the Ranger, which is your beginner suit. Apparently, this was a decision made recently, as confirmed by Ryan Solo Q's tweet to Mark. So what are my thoughts on this? I am 100% all for it. One of the things I missed covering in my absence was that certain things are confirmed to be locked behind your level very briefly in Anthem. For example, you will notice that during the footage from the Our World, Your Story video Anthem released at PAX West, that the Interceptor appears to only have one weapon, when in prior gameplay with the HUD on, all javelins wield two weapons. This led many to believe that the Interceptor would only be able to use one weapon. However, this was cleared up by Mark Darrah in this tweet stating that the Interceptor has two weapon slots. With this cleared up, however, why didn't this Interceptor have two weapons displayed on their HUD? It was revealed that the guy using the Interceptor in the trailer was simply a level 1, which means he has not unlocked his second weapon slot, which is unlocked at level 2. However, Mark states that this is technically impossible, seeing as our freelancer slash pilot's level will be indicative of what we can and cannot have unlocked. So technically, when we first start playing the game, our Ranger will only have one weapon slot unlocked until our pilot hits level 2, allowing us to equip another weapon. However, my whole point for mentioning this is because it seems like Anthem may be going in the direction of level gating certain things. We've already seen indications with it with weapons, we will probably see it again with gear slots, our ultimate ability gear slot, loadouts, and now we're seeing it take the form of level gating with our javelin unlocks. Level gating isn't an uncommon practice in games, and personally, I think it's for the best. It allows us to get used to certain mechanics, suits, abilities, and so on to the point where we are comfortable with moving on to the new and unknown. It's also nice to see the devs make the switch from missions to level gating, at least for the javelins. Like Mark stated, tying the javelin unlocks to missions made unlocking them too late. Knowing me and my day one team, we are more than likely going to be steamrolling through the leveling process in order to get everyone their desired suits so the real work can begin. From a story standpoint, however, this leaves me a bit puzzled as to how we are actually going to get our suits. With the mission approach, I'm sure everything would make sense story-wise. If I wanted my storm suit, I may have to go steal it or claim it in a Dominion mission. If someone wanted the Interceptor, perhaps, they would have to do a mission for Corvus in order to earn it. You get the point. Now, with level gating, I wonder how all of that will work, at least story-wise. For example, I'm now level 5. Woo-hoo. Time to go back to Fort Tarsus to claim my storm javelin? But how? Did Corvus steal it? Did a vendor smuggle it into the city? I don't know. Knowing the incredible people on the storytelling and level design teams, I'm confident all will make sense somehow. We really do appreciate all the hard work the devs put into Anthem and the changes you make for us to be able to enjoy all the goodies sooner. So tell me, freelancers, what will be your unlock order when Anthem releases in February? I'm definitely going with the Storm, Colossus, and then the Interceptor as of right now. Let me know in the comment section below what your order will be. And as always, if you liked the video, please be sure to leave a thumbs up. And if you are new to the channel, consider subscribing for all your Anthem news, lore, and needs. And as ever, a very special thank you to my patrons for all your support. I wouldn't be back today making content if it wasn't for you all. I sincerely hope all of you fantastic freelancers have a phenomenal day. Stay happy and stay positive, my friends, and I will see you all in the next video very soon. Peace out, everyone.